Hi everyone. In this section of the citation management tutorial, we're going to be talking about how to manage your citations in RefWorks. This is going to be an introduction or an overview. It's not really meant to get into all of the features and functions of the software. A good thing to do if you're trying to figure out if this is something that's going to work for you is to sit and play with it for about an hour. RefWorks is a program that lets you manage all of the citations that you use for your research materials. RefWorks is web-based, which means that all of the citations that you collect and organize are saved online, and they're accessible from anywhere that you can access the internet. RefWorks lets you collect the information you need about each of the resources you use, organize those resources into collections that make sense to you, and then format citations and create bibliographies. You can create a RefWorks account for free through the UNC library, and you can keep that account for as long as you'd like, even after you graduate. To get to the RefWorks sign-up or login page, you initially have to do some clicking through the UNC library website. Start on the UNC library website homepage, and then click on Writing and Citing. Over on the right, click on RefWorks. And this gets you to a really great library-created online guide that takes you through some of the basic and more advanced features of RefWorks. Click on Getting Started, and in this box on the right-hand side, you want to click on the RefWorks logo to create your RefWorks account. To create a new account, click Sign Up for a New Account. If you've signed up for a new account, you can simply enter your login name and your password and log into RefWorks. Always make sure, though, that in this box it says University of North Carolina Chapel Hill, especially if you're registering for the account for the first time. That will make sure that you're getting your account for free. Once you've logged into RefWorks for the first time, this is the screen that you're going to see, but we'll explore this a little bit more later after we've imported some resources into our RefWorks collection. You can import citations into RefWorks in a few different ways, and one way is right through the UNC Library catalog. If you find a book that you'd like to import, look over here on the right-hand side, and down at the bottom of this list of options, you see RefWorks. Click on RefWorks, and it will open up in a new tab or a new window. You'll get a series of pop-up boxes, which might seem a little confusing at first, but just remember all you really need to do is come down here to the bottom of the pop-up box and click on View Last Imported Folder. The Last Imported Folder is a temporary folder where things that you've recently imported kind of go. It's sort of a holding area. And so you see that we have a new citation imported here. And we're going to organize some of our citations in just a moment. You can also import citations from most of the library databases that you're going to be using to do your research. We're in Communication and Mass Media Complete right now, and this will look the same whether you're in Communication and Mass Media Complete or in another EBSCO database like Business Source Complete. If there's an article that you'd like to import, click on the title, and over here in this list of options on the right-hand side, click on Export. And so this gives you a few different options for exporting your reference. You want to make sure that the second-to-last box here is checked, Direct Export to RefWorks, and click on Save. Again, this will open up in a new tab in a pop-up window. And again, click on View Last Imported Folder. And you see this is the new reference that we have just imported. To see all of the references that we've imported so far, remember we're looking right now at the last imported folder, which is a temporary holding place, click on References. And here are the two that we've imported. Another way to add a reference to your RefWorks collection is to come up here and click on New Reference. And this will open up a pop-up box and allow you to enter the information manually. You can also add detachments, and you can automatically add it to one of your folders. And we'll go over folders in just a second. First, let's take a look at these citations that we've imported. In this little toolbar up here, there are a couple of different things that you can do. The first is with the magnifying glass icon, you can view the citation. And so this will pull up in a pop-up box all of the information that RefWorks imported from the catalog. You have your abstract, your bibliographic data, and if you'd like to add comments to your citation record, you can do that. Another important thing in this toolbar is this little notepad icon. If you click on this, it'll let you edit that information. This is really important if you want to add comments of your own, if you want to add or change the attachments that you've connected to this citation, or if some of the information that was imported is not quite correct, you can fix it here. And finally, this X removes this from your collection altogether. And this is a permanent delete. Your references in Zotero are organized primarily by folders. If you'd like to create a new folder, come up here to the New Folder button. Give it a name, and you see it appears over here on the right-hand side. If you'd like to add anything to the folder, select it, and come up here to the folder icon with the green button. And this is another area that lists all of your folders, and we're going to add it to our new folder. This doesn't remove it from any of the other folders. You can have items in your RefWorks collection in multiple folders, and in that way, your folders are almost like a tagging system. So let's create another folder. And this time let's add both of these. We'll select both of them and add them both there. And if any time you'd like to see what's in a particular folder, you simply click on that folder's name on the right-hand side and it will bring up those citations. If you'd like to remove an item from a folder, select the item and click on this folder icon with the red button, and that removes it from the folder. That doesn't delete it from your RefWorks account. It's still in the other folder where we placed it. It just removes it from that particular folder. Now, once you have a list of references, and it can get a little unwieldy, there are a couple of different ways that you can view those. You can sort by different facets over here, sort by author's last name, sort by publication year. You can also change the appearance of the citations in your list as you view them to make them more brief or more full. Again, if you'd like to see a list of all of the references that you've imported, come up here and click on References. I've imported a few more resources into my RefWorks account and added them to a sample folder, because the last thing I want to go over is how to create a bibliography using your RefWorks account. The first thing you want to do is click on the folder that you'd like to use and select any of the items that you want to include in that bibliography. And you can check them individually, or you can click on All in List. To create the bibliography, you can come up here to this button, Create Bibliography. Click that, and that'll open up a new pop-up window. From here, you select your citation style and your file type. And your file type is going to depend on what kind of document you're putting this into. And click on Create Bibliography. You'll get a little pop-up box in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen that says Bibliography Complete. You can click to receive a download and click OK to open it. It opens in a new Word file, and here's your bibliography. It's a few different steps and it can be a little confusing, but it really is as simple as a few clicks. You can also click to have the file emailed to you. Enter your email address and click Send File. And this will let you know when the email is sent. always double-check the citations that are in your bibliography to make sure that they're formatted correctly. And if they're not, you can go in and check to see that the information was imported correctly into RefWorks. This has been just a quick overview of some of the main features of RefWorks. If you have any questions, you can check out the RefWorks documentation online. They have some really great, very effective tutorials. We also have on UNC's campus every year a graduate student is trained by the company that makes RefWorks to work with other students on campus and offer support and training on using this product. And so this is the student that will be here until May 2013. Next year there will be a new student trainer, though, available to you. And of course, if you remember how you got into your RefWorks account through the UNC Library catalog, that is an excellent guide that takes you through some of the basic and more advanced features of RefWorks. And finally, of course, we would love you to contact us at the Park Library if you have any questions at all. Feel free to email us, chat us, give us a call, or stop by to visit.